Good afternoon, children. So last class, we learned about different types of cells, the classification of organisms into two or different types of cells based on their nuclear membrane, eukaryotes and prokaryotes. And we learned almost four differences between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. And I want you to tell me the points one by one. Four points are there. Four of you can take turns and tell me the differences between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Yes? Surya?
Yes, ma'am.
No differences between prokaryotes and eukaryotes?
Ma'am, can you repeat those things?
Eukaryotes are the differences between prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. In a tabular column, we explained about four differences between both.
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone point?
Prokaryotes are generally small.
Okay.
Eukaryotes are generally large.
Good. Another person, Ashik. Next point. Ashik Pateri. Any problem in connectivity, Ashik? Aditya Nair, tell me another difference.
Yes, ma'am.
Another difference between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells.
Prokaryotes have nucleus.
And prokaryotes are having nucleus?
No. They're having nuclear membrane.
Louder.
They're having nuclear material, but
nuclear material
nucleus.
Without a
nucleus.
Nuclear membrane. Okay.
Membrane.
Whereas in eukaryotic cell, they have
eukaryotic cell.
Well-defined
nuclear membrane. Well-defined
nucleus with
membrane.
Nuclear membrane. You should revise the last day's portion. Vishnupriya, third point.
There is a single chromosome in prokaryote, and there are more than one.
Very good.
One
last
chromosome.
Last difference. Hadidi.
Membrane-bound cell organelle.
Very good. Membrane-bound cell organelle.
Absent in prokaryotes.
Absent in?
Prokaryotes.
Yes, very good. And
membrane-bound in eukaryotes.
Okay. So these are the differences. And one more question. What do you mean by a nucleoid?
Nuclear membrane.
Arjun? Repeat. What is meant by a nucleoid?
Nuclear membrane.
An undefined nuclear
region
contains
Tell me.
An undefined nuclear region which contains nucleic acid.
Only nucleic acid. Very good. Very good. Okay. So all this we had covered, and we also discussed about cytoplasm, the jelly-like substance present between the nucleus and the plasma membrane. And scattered in the cytoplasm, you can find different cell organelles. Today we are going to learn about the different cell organelles, their structure and functions. So one by one, we will analyze each organelle and let us learn about the different structure and functions of these organelles. Okay, so last class when we discussed about the cell organelles, I told you that these are tiny cellular structures. These are tiny cellular structures which perform specific functions in a cell. So till here we had seen last class. I'll repeat once again. tiny cellular structures that perform specific functions within a cell are known as cell organelles. There are different types of cell organelles like plastid, endoplasmic reticulum, vacuole, lysosome, Golgi complex, ribosomes, mitochondria, etc. So many cell organelles are present, and each cell organelle is having a specific function. Each cell organelle, they perform a specific function. If one organelle carries out a synthesis of protein, another one will be carrying out cleaning of the cell. If one is carrying out cleaning of the cell, other one will be carrying out transportation. So each organelle, they perform specific functions within a cell. So today, to begin with, we are going to learn about the first organelle, that is endoplasmic reticulum. So we are going to learn about the first organelle, that is endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, and endoplasmic reticulum.
Ma'am, can you show the last slide one more time?
Last slide. Okay. So tiny cellular structures that perform specific functions within a cell are known as cell organelles. And each one is having a specific function. There are different types like endoplasmic reticulum, plastid, lysosome, vacuole, Golgi complex, mitochondrion, ribosome, etc. About each one you are going to learn now. Okay, now we are moving on to the next slide. And the first organelle we are going to discuss is endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum.
Vivian, ma'am.
Yes? You are saying something, children? Endoplasmic reticulum. Any doubt means ask. Anybody is having doubt? Okay. Endoplasmic reticulum. Now let's see what are these organelles. Endoplasmic reticulum is a network of membrane-bound tubes and sheaths. As you can see in the figure, you can see tube-like structures or sheet-like structures. You can see tube-like or sheet-like structures. You call them as endoplasmic reticulum. It looks like tubules. Tubules means small tubes are known as tubules. They look like small tubules or round or oblong. Oblong means elongated, bag-like structures. They'll be either in the form of tubes, small tubes, or in the form of elongated or round bag-like structures. I'll repeat once again. Endoplasmic reticulum, it's a network. They form a network of membrane bound. It's a membrane bound organelle, membrane bound tubes and sheets. Now appearance, they look like tubules. Tubules means long tube, sorry, small tubule or small tube is known as tubule. Smaller tubes are known as tubules. Or they look like round or oblong or elongated bag-like structures. That is about its structure. Okay, any clarification needed? Endoplasmic reticulum is a cell organelle which is a network of membrane bound tubes and sheets.
Doubt.
Oh, yes. Aman, what's your doubt?
Hi, what is vesicles?
Vesicles means bag like structures. That is what is why it is put in brackets. Bag-like structures are known as vesicles. Okay, It consists of a network of membrane-bound tubes and sheets. In appearance, they either look like bags, bag-like structures, or small tubes. Small tubes are tubules. Okay? Now, there are two types of endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum. In the previous figure, it was a little more clear. So here you can find two types of endoplasmic reticulum. One is rough. So this one you can see, these are rough in appearance because on the surface of these you can find some structures like this. Some other structures are found attached to its surface, making it very rough. And these structures, you call them as ribosomes. Ribosomes. And endoplasmic reticulum with ribosomes attached to it are known as rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay? Once again, so there are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, rough and smooth. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is having certain structures attached with known as ribosomes. Ribosomes are attached to the surface of rough endoplasmic reticulum, which makes its surface very rough. What are those structures? Ribosomes are present on the surface of rough endoplasmic reticulum, giving it a rough appearance. Whereas in smooth endoplasmic reticulum, no ribosomes. So its surface will be smooth. So we have two types of endoplasmic reticulum, rough and smooth. Rough endoplasmic reticulum, they are having ribosomes attached to it. Whereas in smooth endoplasmic reticulum, no ribosomes. When ribosomes are present, the surface becomes rough. And ribosomes are very important organelles. They are very important structures. And they are the sites of protein manufacture. It is in these ribosomes that synthesis of proteins takes place. I'll repeat once again, children. We were discussing about endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is a very important organelle. And about the structure, it consists of a network of membrane-bound tubes and sheets. And in appearance, they look like small tubes or round or elongated bag-like structures known as vesicles. Okay? Known as vesicles. Now coming to the types of endoplasmic reticulum, there are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, rough and smooth. Rough endoplasmic reticulum has got ribosomes attached to its surface, which makes its surface rough. Whereas ribosomes are absent in smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Clear? And the function of ribosomes. Ribosomes are the sites of protein manufacture. These are the places, these are the organelles where synthesis of proteins takes place. Clear, children? Any doubt? Any doubt?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Any point to be repeated? So we were discussing about endoplasmic reticulum. What are the two types of endoplasmic reticulum? Nirupama? Two types.
Smooth endoplasmic reticulum and
smooth
rough
endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum. What is the major difference between both, Ashik? What is the major difference between both? Ashik? Ashik? Anjida? Anjida? What is the main difference between both, rough and smooth?
rough endoplasmic reticulum have ribosomes on it?
Yes,
which
rough endoplasmic reticulum has got ribosomes attached to it, which makes its surface rough. Suppose if you sprinkle something, maybe some sand particles, if you sprinkle on a smooth surface, it will become rough because of the sand particles attached to it. Similarly, when ribosomes are present on the surface, the endoplasmic reticulum will get a rough appearance. Clear? Clear, children? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the function of ribosome? What function do the ribosomes perform? Meghna, what is the role of ribosome? Meghna?
Ribosomes are the sites of protein manufacture.
Very good. They are the sites of protein manufacture where the protein synthesis will take place. Clear? So again, I'm continuing. No doubts? I'm stopping in between so that if any doubts are there, we can clear it off.
Ma'am, can you explain?
So we learned about the structure, types also we learned. Now we are going to learn about the functions of endoplasmic reticulum. Quite a number of functions are there. So you will have to learn these functions. All these functions should be learned. Okay. So many functions are given. One by one, we will see all the functions. Starting with the first one. So let us begin with the first one. Rough endoplasmic reticulum. You know that ribosomes are attached to it, and we learned that ribosomes are the site of protein synthesis. So rough endoplasmic reticulum will help in the synthesis of proteins. Remember, rough endoplasmic reticulum will help in the synthesis of proteins, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum will help in the synthesis of lipids. Lipids means fats. Okay. So once again, first function, rough endoplasmic reticulum helps in the synthesis of proteins. You will not have any confusion because you know that rough ones only ribosomes are there. In ribosomes only protein synthesis will take place. So definitely proteins are synthesized by rough endoplasmic reticulum, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum will synthesize lipids. Clear? The first function. First function is clear. Now, next one. Some of the proteins and lipids. Some proteins and lipids synthesized by them will be used up or will be used for building up the cell membrane. Already you have learned plasma membrane is made up of proteins and lipids. Plasma membrane is flexible membrane made up of proteins and lipids. Hope you are remembering it. So some of the proteins and lipids synthesized by endoplasmic reticulum will be used for building up the cell membrane. That process is known as membrane biogenesis. So if you are asked what is membrane biogenesis, you can say that some of the proteins and lipids produced by the endoplasmic reticulum is used for building up cell membrane. This is known as membrane biogenesis. Okay. Now, some other proteins and lipids, they will act as or they will function as enzymes and hormones. I'll repeat all the functions, all the three functions once again. First function, rough endoplasmic reticulum synthesizes proteins. Smooth one will synthesize lipids. Second point, some of the proteins and lipids synthesized by them are used for building up our membrane, cell membrane. You call the process as membrane biogenesis. But are all the proteins and lipids used up for that? No. Some of them will act as enzymes and hormones. Some proteins and lipids are used for building up cell membrane. Some of them are functioning as enzymes and hormones. I'll repeat once again. Rough endoplasmic reticulum will synthesize proteins. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum will synthesize lipids. So So they both of them together will produce proteins and lipids. Some of these proteins and lipids are used for building up the cell membrane. You call it as membrane biogenesis. And some of them will function as enzymes and hormones. Any doubt? Any doubt, children?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. Now moving on to next. Three more functions are there. Next function is endoplasmic reticulum. They will act as channels, or they will act as passage. What for? To transport materials, for transporting materials between different parts of cytoplasm or between the cytoplasm and the nucleus. So the next function is endoplasmic reticulum. They will act as channels. Channels for what? For transportation. Transporting what? Materials. To where? To different parts of the cytoplasm and also between the cytoplasm and the nucleus. Now the next function. It forms a cytoplasmic framework. Endoplasmic reticulum. They will form a framework to provide a surface for different biochemical activities, which means that the different biochemical activities are taking place in endoplasmic reticulum. It's a network. So on that, or it will provide a surface to carry out different biochemical activities. Last and final function, smooth endoplasmic reticulum found in the liver cells of vertebrates helps in detoxifying poisons and drugs. Detoxifying means making it toxin free or making it harmless. Making it harmless. So once again, the last three functions we'll repeat. It acts as channels. What for? Channels are meant for transporting. Transporting what? Materials. To where are they transporting? Between different parts of the cytoplasm or between the cytoplasm and the nucleus. Okay? Next function. It acts as a cytoplasmic framework. What for? To provide a surface for different biochemical activities. And the last one. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum found in the liver of vertebrates. We are also vertebrates. Human beings, all the organisms having vertebral column are vertebrates. We are an example for that. Okay? We also form an example of vertebrates. So in the liver cells of vertebrates, like human beings, smooth endoplasmic reticulum plays a very important role. They help in the detoxification of, they help in the detoxification of poisons and drugs. So once again, all the functions of endoplasmic reticulum, in rough endoplasmic reticulum will produce proteins, smooth endoplasmic reticulum will produce lipids. Some of the proteins and lipids are used for building up the cell membrane. You call it as membrane biogenesis. Some will act as enzymes and hormones. Learn now itself. Some will act as enzymes and hormones. Now coming to the next function. They act as channels. For what? Transporting materials. To where? To different parts of the cytoplasm or between cytoplasm and nucleus. Next function. It acts as a cytoplasmic framework. What for? For different biochemical activities of the cell to take place. Last and one very important function is rough endoplasmic reticulum present in vertebrate liver. Liver, the largest organ in your, largest gland in your body. In the liver, the poisons and drugs are detoxified with the help of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Was it tough, children? So many. Prajot? Now can you hear? No problem in hearing, no? Okay. Any doubt in the functions, children? Any doubts in the functions? Okay. One of you tell me one function whom I'll ask. Adidev, tell me any one function of endoplasmic reticulum.
Smooth endoplasmic reticulum found in liver of vertebrates, placing major role in detoxifying poisons and drugs.
Very good. Wonderful. Who is next? Who is next? Lolita. Very good. Lolita, tell me.
One function of the endoplasmic serve as channels for the transport of materials between different regions of cytoplasm or between the cytoplasm.
Very good. Very good. Today you people are responding so nicely. Who is next? Who is next? Don't wait for me to
some
call.
Some other protein cell.
That's it, Nirupama. Yes, tell me.
Some other proteins and lipids function as enzymes and hormones.
Very good. Some of the proteins and lipids produced by endoplasmic reticulum function as enzymes and hormones. Next one. We have so many students in the class. One by one, fast. Yes, good. Tell me.
Transport of materials between various regions of the cytoplasm and between.
Okay, but already Lolita told that point. Anyway, good. Any other point?
It functions as cytoplasmic
framework for what type?
Surface for some of the biochemical activities.
Very good. It provides a cytoplasmic framework for different biochemical activities to take place within the cell. Now, next one. Rihan, very good. Tell me, Rihan.
A major role in the detoxifying poison.
Rihan, speak loudly, please.
In the liver cells of vertebrates, SCR plays a major role in the detoxifying poison and drugs.
Sorry, child, I'm not able to hear you. Can you speak a little more louder?
In the liver cells.
In the liver cells.
Plays a major role in the detoxifying poison.
Okay, good. But already that point also, it was told by Adidev. Any other point? What is membrane biogenesis? Who will tell me that?
Some of the proteins and lipids.
Yes, Rifa. Good. Tell me.
Some of the proteins and lipids produced by the help in building the cell membrane, and
that is known as membrane biogenesis. Okay, very good, children. We'll continue next class. So revise today's portions and come. Thank you. See you next class.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Goodbye, children.
Thank you.